All right, so now let's get into the logical problem of evil. It seems like the following claims are logically inconsistent. It seems like if 1 through 4 are true, that's impossible. Seems like that's impossible. Now, what I mean by this is, for something to be logically inconsistent, it means that you've got a contradiction in a group of claims. A contradiction in a group of claims or a group of beliefs. When you say that these statements are inconsistent, it doesn't mean that they're all false, but it means that they can't be true all simultaneously. You got to get rid of at least one. If you accept 3 to be true, you can't accept a 4th one. So, it seems like it's impossible that God could be omniscient, omnipotent, and omnibenevolent, yet evil exists. It seems like that's the case. Why? Because if God is omniscient, then God knows about evil, and if he's omnipotent, then he would be able to prevent evil. And if he's omnibenevolent, he would want to prevent evil. So, how on earth can you have all 3 of those at the same time and there still be evil? So, you could just say evil doesn't exist, or maybe you want to deny that God exists. Or maybe you want to deny one of those 3 attributes that is commonly attributed to God. So that's the setup. It seems like you can't have all 4 of these claims be true at the same time. And because it would follow logically, since it's a question of whether it's logically consistent, that's why it's called a logical problem of evil. Now, we could motivate this logical problem of evil in terms of a famous philosopher, Epicurus. He is the founder of the Epicurean school of thought, and if you go to a website, Epicurus, it's supposed to be like a play on his name. Now, Epicurus has like a lot of different things that he talked about, but one of them, and he's an ancient Greek philosopher, one of them is he poses a question about like how it could be that evil exists when there's this good God. So he asks the question, is God willing to prevent evil, but he's not able? Then God is not omnipotent. If he's willing, but not able, he doesn't have the ability to do everything. So if God's omnipotent, he would. Is he able, but unwilling? Well, then he's not a good God. He's malevolent. It's not just that he's not omnibenevolent, he's malevolent. He's willing to turn a blind eye and neglect us. But if God is both able and willing, then why the heck would there be evil? If God's able and he doesn't want there to be evil, then of course God would do something about it. So then where does evil come from? But suppose God's not able, or God's not willing, then why the heck would you worship him? Why would you pray to him? Why would you call him God? It seems like that kind of God is not a God worthy of the name. Why call him God?